over rescue 9. What's this for?
Bad crash. We need you guys both as fast as you can get here. Rescue 24 is on site helping.
Weatherman for rescue 9, do you copy? We're gonna need an ambulance.
About a month and a half ago, we got a phone call from Ducati wanting to know if we would like to partner up and go racing. It took about 2 seconds, and we said, absolutely. I'd like you to meet two of the Fasthouse crew members, Jordan Graham and Ricky Diaz. Jordan has desert racing in his blood. And Ricky, he's a soul rider. They found themselves cruising to one of the gnarliest desert races on the planet, the Men 400. Once they got into town, they had to go to sign up, just to make sure everything was cool and ready to go for the big day. And they did it right. Well, I think we're getting ahead of ourselves. About a week ago, we got to go check out the bikes for the first time. Boys were definitely impressed.
I'm Ricky.
Nice to meet you.
You as well. Hey, Michael.
Jordan, you do.
How are you?
So let's check these things out. You guys put a lot of time into these things.
Shit. Look at the names on here, Ricky. I got a name on one.
On all the pegs? All right, which one's mine?
All right, cool. Leading up to the whole Mint 400 weekend, talking to the bike builders, talking to Kenny, talking to Ricky, I don't think going into it I expected what was presented in front of us. We hopped on the bikes and immediately started swapping and having a good time. And I knew by seeing Ricky's grin that we were in this thing.
Depending on how it goes, it could seriously be another class.
Yeah, like you said, I think you hit it, Jordan. I was not picturing that original phone call, like, do you want to go ride a Scrambler in the 400? I was like, you're nuts. You're insane. But now, like, all right.
Got through a tech inspection. It was just nice standing back and looking at the bikes. Well, it was time. After all the hard work the crews put in, endless hours, planning, it was time to go have some fun.
In the night and a sudden today. everything gets easier once the flag drops.
Straddled hunks of iron and hauled ass across the desert, ignoring the smell of death. Just like the guys who got us here today, that built traditions, blazed new trails, and became legends. In the course, you're moving so fast that you don't have time to think about what can go wrong. You're aware of how badly it can go at any second, yet your right hand is still twisting the throttle, searching for more.
Hearing the chopper chase us hour after hour was an unforgettable sound. Having just gone through the most brutal race in North America on a 500-pound motorcycle for 4.5 hours, that checkered flag was the best thing I've ever seen.
It was super cool to see Jordan get the checkers and ride the bike up on the stage. It doesn't get much better than this.
Oh, Michael, you earned it. Now I need water, so I can drink.
Jordan kicked ass, brought home the win, and the crew, we were all smiles. And for Ricky, that's racing. He was stoked. We saved him a couple of cold ones.
This is the closest you've been to me all day.
I should have just taken care of it right there.
Yeah, I know. You blew past me, and I was like, oh, that was it for the day. Sorry, Ricky.
I mean, like, what was going on there? Were you in third?
Yeah, I was cruising. I was checking Instagram, actually. I was just showing you half.
So I think this time next year we line up again.
Yeah, I say we do it again. You got to try to beat me this time.
Try to beat. I'm just going to rip that front brake when I have the chance to do it.
I'm going to let you beat me to the truck right now, so
whatever,
give you a little bit of glory.
Whatever, dude. Just stay in your own lane over there.
Hopefully you finish that beer better than...